Hello everyone. Up till now, we had seen principal stress strain and how to find out that we have seen by analytical method. Now we are going to see the graphical method, that again we can call it as a Mohr's circle method. So in 1882, Otto Mohr, he is a German engineer, developed this graphical method to finding out the principal stress, normal and tangential stress in a strained material with the help of the circle, and that circle is known as the Mohr circle. In Mohr circle, the normal stresses are plotted along the horizontal axis and the shear stresses are plotted along the vertical axis. Few sign conventions that we will see here. As always, we have seen that the tensile stresses are considered as a positive, whereas the compressive stresses are considered as a negative. Shear stress, which tend to rotate the element in clockwise direction, are considered as positive. And the shear stress which tend to rotate the element in anticlockwise direction are considered as a negative. The tensile stresses are plotted to right of the origin O and compressive to the left. So here the axis we are drawn, this is the horizontal axis, this is the vertical axis. And we had seen just that the tensile stress, that is the normal stress, that is the sigma, if it is positive from this origin, we will take towards right hand side. If it is negative from the origin, towards left hand side. And if shear stress is there and the value is positive, then we will plot above this origin O, and if the shear stress is negative, then we will mark below this O. Thus, positive shear stress are plotted above origin O and the negative below O. Now suppose this is an element and on which there is a shear stress that is acting, due to which if you are getting this clockwise moment, then we can set as a positive shear. This is again element on horizontal axis, horizontal plane, if the shear stress is acting, and due to that if you are getting this clockwise moment, that also we can call it as a positive shear stress. And if the element and on vertical plane shear stress is acting, and due to which if you are getting the anticlockwise moment, then we can call it as a negative shear stress. Again, the fourth case, the shear stress acting on the horizontal plane, and due to which if you are getting the anticlockwise moment, then again this we can consider it as a negative shear stress. So these are the sign conventions. Now we will see actual procedure how to draw this Mohr circle. So this is one given element and on which the sigma x tensile stress acting along the x direction, sigma y tensile stress along the y direction, and the shear stress tau, it is acting on the plane. And here we are considering an oblique plane at an angle theta. This theta we are measuring from this vertical plane and again in anticlockwise direction. Now we will see the Mohr circle, how to draw for this condition. So first we will draw the horizontal axis, and this is the vertical axis. On horizontal axis, this is the origin, that is point O. Now on horizontal axis, from point O towards right hand, positive sigma, and towards left, negative sigma. From this point above this line, positive shear stress, and below this line, that is the negative shear stress. So on vertical plane, sigma x, it is a tensile. So we consider some suitable scale, and from this origin we will mark the point which indicates the value of sigma x. This is one point A. So this O to A, this length represents the value of the sigma x, which is acting on this horizontal plane. Horizontal direction on vertical plane. Now we will plot the sigma y. Again, this is the positive value. So by converting into scale, and we will plot towards the right hand side. Again, it is the positive value. So from this, we will mark the sigma y value, and here we will get the point B. So what we did, the sigma x and sigma y both are positive value. So we took towards the right hand side by assuming some suitable scale. Now on this vertical plane, or the plane on which sigma x is acting, on that the shear stress tau it is acting, and due to which what you will get, which type of moment? It is rotating in anti-clockwise moment. So on the vertical plane, shear stress and anti-clockwise moment, that we are considering it as a negative. So sigma x value is at point A, and on that it is negative, means we have to take in the downward direction. So whatever the shear stress value tau, by considering again the scale which you assume, with that we will mark in the downward direction. This is the point AZ, A2G, which represents the shear stress on this vertical plane. Now next, similarly shear stress on the horizontal plane where sigma y is there, on that the shear stress, due to this shear stress due to which you will get clockwise moment, that is the positive shear stress. So from this horizontal axis we will mark in upward direction, that is B2EH. Now we mark all the things, O2A sigma x, O2B sigma y, A2G shear stress on this vertical plane, B2H shear stress on horizontal plane. Now here we got H and G point, and that will join with the line. This HG represents as a diameter of the Mohr circle. So as this is crossing the horizontal line, so here we will mark it as a center C. By taking center C and CH as a radius, or CG as a radius, we will draw one circle. And this circle is nothing but it is a Mohr's circle. Now we will mark few things. So this is point P, this is point Q, this is the vertical axis which we had drawn, that is point R, this is point S. Now we have to mark this oblique plane from this vertical, the angle theta. So sigma x and tau are resultant here, this CG. From this CG line we will measure the angle, that is of 2 theta. Here theta they have given, here 2 theta angle always we take here while plotting that the plane, 2 theta. So all the angle from this Mohr circle we will get the 2 theta angle. So this we will mark, that is of the oblique plane. Now that is point D we are marking. If I take in downward direction, it will cross the horizontal axis. Here that point I am marking it as a E. Now from this CG, when we move in anticlockwise direction, and if it meets to this sigma x, so that angle we can call it as a 2 theta P, that is a position of principal plane. Now again, if I measure from this CG line to the vertical, to this CR, that is what, position of the shear plane. Now we had drawn all these things. From this we have to find out major principal stress, minor principal stress, major principal plane, minor principal plane, tau max, all these things, sigma n, normal stress on that, all these things we can find out. So we will find the sigma 1 is the highest value in this stress system. So on horizontal axis we get the sigma value. So highest value is what, from O to P. This is what we can call it as a major principal stress. And where is the lowest value? O to Q. This we can call it as a minor principal stress. Now from this we have taken an angle 2 theta. and we got the CD line and that we joined. So this vertical line, it represents as a tau, positive tau. So that is the, this is the oblique plane, and on this the tau means this is the tau theta. But the tau max, if you want to find out what is the tau max, the vertical distance which will get the maximum value. So the circle of the circle we had drawn, the radius of that circle, it represents the maximum shear. So this C to R, it represents the maximum tau max. Now this E to D, we consider an angle 2 theta, and corresponding that tau is what we can call it as a tau theta. Then this horizontal O to E, this is the tau theta, and that is corresponding sigma theta. This is the sigma n, where tau max corresponding sigma n. So this O to C, it represents the sigma n, normal stress on a plane where maximum shear stress is there. This is the maximum shear stress, C to R tau max. Now when I join this O to D, so we know this is the sigma theta which we represented, this is the tau theta, and we know the equation sigma R is equal to sigma theta square plus tau theta square, square root of that is the resultant stress. So this represents O to D, the sigma R, and the angle of obliquity, that is tan phi is equal to tau theta upon sigma theta. So tau theta is what? Front side, sigma theta is adjacent side, so this is front. So this is the angle of obliquity phi. So these are the few things which you can find out. O to P sigma 1, O to Q sigma 2, then this A to D tau theta, C to R, that is the tau max, then this from CZ to in anticlockwise direction, oblique plane is anticlockwise, so in anticlockwise direction 2 theta, this CD, and this DE is what? Tau theta, and this OE is the sigma theta, and this OD is the sigma R, and this angle DO, this E is nothing but the angle of obliquity, that is the phi. From this CZ in anticlockwise direction, where we will get the first, this sigma X line, that is the 2 theta P. So from this angle 2 theta P will get, and divided by 2 we will get the theta P1, first principal plane position. And from same this line in anticlockwise direction, where it cuts to the tau line, so that is the 2 theta S1, so position of the first shear plane. Now if you want to find out second principal plane, from this point if we rotate, so if I, from this point if I rotate, so up to this, that is 2 theta, that is P2 you will get. And if I rotate from this point to again up to this, I will get 2 theta S2. This is what the overall, the Mohr circle, how to draw, and from that how to find out all this value. So at the last we will measure this distance and multiply with the scale, we will get all the value. So thank you for watching, and subscribe to our channel.